Peace TV English, the solution for humanity.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And we are back, so we'll continue with our guest, Fadl Sulaiman, who is the director of the Bridges Foundation, which is an organization that trains people to teach non-Muslims about Islam. And we are continuing with our topic, humbleness versus arrogance. In light of our present-day situation, the way people think, generally people think that someone who is humble is weak. Now, we want to say, for example, that you are the head of a company, as you are the head of a Dawah organization. How can you, at the same time, be humble and kind to the people who are with you, but at the same time, you need to exert a level of authority over them so that they will not see you as a weak person, and in which case you'll constantly have difficulty? How can you balance the two?
Hey, this is what we call leadership. Leadership is not by giving orders. Leading by example is the best way to lead. And many people, even people whom we call religious people, we say, no, we don't act arrogantly. Why should we watch that show? But they should think, yes, you may not be acting arrogantly towards your friend or your neighbor, but are you sure you don't act arrogantly when you deal with your office boy, when you deal with the servants who help at home? Sometimes we even backbite them. And we say, we are very careful, we don't backbite people. But when it comes to a meeting like that, we say, you know what? I have a very stupid servant who works for me at home. Mm-hmm. This is very arrogant. And people should be very careful with that. So we can lead by example, but at the same time also be careful. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught us. He said, that's a hadith that Abu Huraira narrated. It said that if your servant got all the heat and the smoke of cooking your food, take his hand and let him sit down and eat with him. If he refused and insisted, then at least give him the portion that he would eat with your own hand.
Just a few weeks ago, I had the pleasure to go and visit one of the reciters. Of his father is 93, 94 years old. So I wanted to ask his father to give me some advice in terms of how to raise children, because I see his son as somebody who's a very respectable person. His father said, always let your children see you dealing justly, kindly, and humbly with the people. And a man who's 93 years old, having raised many children, and half of the Quran, I took this to be something major. What do you think about his advice?
That's what I told you. Leading by example. That's what Anas said. I served the Prophet, peace be upon him, for 10 whole years. He never criticized me. He never shouted at me. He never called me names. He never even told me, why did you do this? Why did you do that? It's leading by example.
Is there a such thing as praiseworthy pride?
What I know is only in the battlefield. When Prophet Muhammad said, who will take this sword and he will be using it till it breaks, and Al-Qaqa ibn Amr took it and he kept on walking with pride with it, trying to scare the enemy. He said, this is a walk that Allah hates except in this situation.
Yes.
That's what I know, actually.
Is there a certain type of... As you know, there are sometimes people who try to give the impression of humbleness, as we made mention about already. So they may walk with their prayer mats along their shoulders and such like that and all. And trying to give a false impression that they are humble people. What advice do you have to people who do things of this nature?
My advice to them is that showing off is a terrible sin in Islam. And some people are showing off with their cars or their villas or their valuable watches. But some people, on the other hand, are trying also to show off by showing their very religious attitude. By trying to put, as you say, a prayer rug on their shoulders or trying to show it somehow.
Well, and you do notice sometimes when people enter into gatherings. For example, we're sitting here and someone were to enter and they expect and like that the fact that people would stand up to greet them. And if you don't stand up, they feel as if they feel put off, if you understand my meaning.
Yeah, I know.
What do you think about that?
There's a statement for Ali ibn Abi Talib that whoever wants to know a person who would be going to hellfire should see a person who likes people to stand for him. And it's all about discipline. People should be receiving a good deal of education and disciplining. They should be very careful of thinking who they really are. Allah Ta'ala said, وَبَدَأَ خَلْقَ الْإِنسَانِ مِنْ طِينَ ثُمَّ جَعَلَ نَسْلَهُ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ مَاءٍ مَهِينَ, which means that Allah had started the creation of man from clay. And then He made His offspring out of semen of worthless water. One of these scholars said, I am surprised. How can a person who flew twice from the same passage of urine be arrogant or act proudly? So people sometimes they forget that all their success or their wealth is from Allah. And they think that it is out of their own production efforts. Or their own efforts.
And just as easily it can be taken away.
Yeah.
Now, what's very important, in order to seek a cure, you must know the sickness. So I wanted to know what some people actually think when you ask them the question, what is the difference between an arrogant person and a humble person? Because if you know the difference between the two, you can then look inside yourself and you can see or say, I have this characteristic or not. But if you can't recognize the difference between the two, then you know you're in trouble. So let's see what some of the people responded to that question. Let's take a look.
It's not what's the difference, what's the similarity. There are no similarities between a humble person and an arrogant person. An arrogant person believes he's the only person that anyone should listen to, believes that everything should go his way. And a humble person is someone who cares about other people, who cares about how they feel. An arrogant person is not like that. Humble is Islam. I mean, Islam is a humble religion. It teaches Muslims to be humble. Arrogance is not from our religion.
A humble person is, plays the role of who he really is in life. But an arrogant person plays the role of a fake or imaginary person that he is really not.
What do you think of his response?
Excellent. I think those youth are great. They really get to the point, and all their comments, I believe it suits the answer of who is an arrogant person and who is a humble person.
Well, first I just ask Allah that we can be of the humble people, because you know, the more I hear about it, the more it feels like a personal challenge.
And that's the effect it's supposed to have.
You know, I mean, but I think you know, most people have a sense, and this may be maybe one of these things. We almost have a natural sense of the kind of behavior that is good. But again, it's the as you said, tarbiyat and nafs, to train yourself to embody that and to respect it in others, inshallah.
Yeah. Well, we have some questions from some members of our studio audience, so let's go directly to them. And where is my first question? First question is.
Yes, I'm Abu Yusuf, and I'm from Albania, and I have a question, and it is. Does humbleness means that to be humble with believers of other religions, as example, the Jewish, Christian, and Buddhist?
That's a very good question, actually. Humbleness means being humble with Allah, by getting closer to Him, knowing your real values, and also with people. People differ. Allah Ta'ala described the believers as people who are humble to their brothers. ذِلَّةٍ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ عِزَّةٍ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. But when they deal with the non-Muslims, they deal with proud. But here, it doesn't mean with arrogance still. It means that I can leave some of my rights to my brother. But when it comes to my rights that are taken from me from a non-Muslim, here comes my my duty to regain back my right. But if this non-Muslim is acting towards me with kindness, I should also show justice and kindness towards him. So yes, you can act humbly with people from other faiths. So this is my answer to this. You can do that as long as they are not transgressors who are transgressing against Muslims. We cannot go and say, well, those people are who transgressed against us and they threw our brothers and sisters out of their homes, we will show them kindness and no, we can't do that. This is not then humbleness. This is disgrace. This is people who are disgracing themselves and acting lowly.
Okay. We're going to continue our discussion and we're going to take some questions from our studio audience. So please stay with us, relax for just a few short minutes, and we'll be right back with our guests, Fadl Sulaiman and Musa McGuire. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Where truth is hidden, misleading quotations create confusion. Where truth is hidden, lack of knowledge and wisdom cause upheaval and commotion. Where truth is hidden, manipulated scriptures and twisted facts emerge. This very hidden truth creates false propaganda, mayhem, chaos, disorder, and turmoil in our lives and the world order. But is there anyone with courage and wisdom? What is the truth, and who has the courage to expose it? Because it's your right to know the truth.
Watch Truth Prevail and Lies Perish in Truth Exposed by Dr. Zakir Naik every Sunday to Friday at 9 p.m. and repeat telecast at 7:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV. Marriage or divorce?
What's Islamic ruling?
Nikah.
Solution or problem?
Islam to
heaven or hell?
There is a misconception.
You choose. Beauty, wealth, family status, virtue. Decide what you want. Decide your choice. Be sad or be happy. It's your choice. Join Dr. Zakir Naik in Better Half or Bitter Half every Friday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
Scientific notions in the glorious Quran are among its endless aspects that can testify for the divine nature of this noble book. These scientific notions are probably the best addressed to the people of our time.
I am Zaghloul al-Najjar. Please join me in this program to discuss some aspects of the scientific notions in the glorious Quran.
Hatta
appreciate the word-to-word authenticity of scientific notions and proven facts mentioned in the glorious Quran 1400 years ago in Scientific Notions in the Glorious Quran. Next on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And hopefully you have gone to the refrigerator, gotten something to drink and some sweets, and now we're back. So we'll continue with our guest, Fadl Sulaiman, who is the director of the Bridges Foundation. It's an organization that trains people to teach non-Muslims about Islam. And we are continuing with our topic, humbleness versus arrogance. Well, we have some questions from some members of our studio audience. So let's go directly to them.
I am Yunus from Nigeria. My question is, when somebody among Muslim brothers is arrogant, how can we behave with him?
First of all, you should be patient. Don't say, I don't deserve that. Maybe you deserve it. Okay? And Allah is you are receiving this kind of treatment because Allah is testing you, your patience. So be patient. That's number one. Number two, try to remind him somehow of the Prophet of Allah and how he used to deal with people. Try to remind him also that punishment always comes from the same category or the same type of the sin itself. Allah Ta'ala told us in Surah Al-Qasas about Qarun, you know Qarun, that فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ فِي زِينَتِهِ, that so he went forth before his people in his pomp. And then what was punishment? فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ, so we allowed the earth to swallow him and his dwellings. So here the punishment came from the same category or the same type of the sin itself. We need to remind each other and advise each other of how we should treat each other. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al-mu'min mir'atu akhi." The believer is like a mirror to his fellow brother. What do you see in the mirror? Not yourself. I know how I look. I see my defects. I look at the mirror to comb or brush this part in my head, or to fix my clothes. And when everything is ready, I go. I don't want to see myself. So the believer is a mirror for his brother, which means that he can show him his weaknesses. But there are etiquettes for doing this. Like giving an advice to your brother in front of people is like scandaling him. It's not really giving him an advice. So we can say, well, Brother Musa, why don't both of us become mirrors to each other? Anything that you see in me, please tell me, and I won't be mad of you. And would you like me to do the same thing? You would say, yes, inshallah, akhi. Then let's do that. You see? Try to ease things for him, and then you can start giving him some gifts, some advices.
Okay. Our next question is...
I asked this question because I suppose we've all seen this kind of character before, but can a person ever be too humble, like a person not willing to forbid an evil or correct a wrong out of a false sense of humbleness?
I don't think this is too humble, but this is a sickness, going to the extreme of being just shy and not doing the what Allah, or the orders of Allah. The scholar said that those who abstain from doing the righteous deeds because they want to act humbly like that, they are afraid of being showing off. This is showing off. No, you need to do the righteous deed. You need to do the right thing, the good work, and always correct your niyyah, correct your intention. Enjoining good and forbidding evil, that's not an option. You need to do that. This is one of the things, this is one of the human rights that Islam gave to you as a Muslim, as a person who is living in an Islamic country, even if you're not a Muslim. You need to be enjoining good and forbidding evil, which is what we call in the United Nations freedom of speech.
You mentioned about purity of intention and such like that. If you have a person who does some work For example, he might be an engineer. And he likes for people to praise his work, as this is a way that he gleans whether people are pleased with his work or not. And he does like to, I mean, everyone likes to feel that they do good work. Is this a form of arrogance if he likes for people to praise him because of his work?
All questions are good tonight. That's also another good question. Here, when we speak about this, no, this is someone who wants an evaluation for his work. Like somebody who is distributing an evaluation form, trying to get comments. But believe it or not, in the evaluation forms that I distribute for the non-Muslims, after I give them a presentation about Islam, when I see them telling me, excellent, 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 I really don't care about this. What I want is the criticism, because I learn from the criticism. But let's speak a little bit about the righteous work, like things like fasting, extra days, like Mondays and Thursdays, or praying extra prayers. If you are having the good intention, or if your intention is not pure here, you need to watch yourself and see the amount of love that you have that people would praise you. Like, for instance, I am going out and I'm fasting today, and then I think to myself, what if somebody offered me a drink today and I would say to him, oh, thank you, I'm fasting. If I thought like that, this is the amount of arrogance that I have, or the amount of impure intention that I have. So when someone offers me a drink, I should tell him, thank you, I don't want it. Or thank you, I can't. But I shouldn't say, I'm fasting. Extra good work should not be displayed. Okay? Same thing, because always the shaitan plays on this, on your intention. You say, okay, I decided to pray tonight Qiyamul Layl, standing in adoration for Allah tonight, for 2 hours. And then the shaitan comes to me, tells me, are you crazy? You stand up and you pray 5 times every day, this is enough. And I say, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem. I am going to do what I decided. And then when you're putting your prayer rug, he tells you, come on, 15 minutes is okay. A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem. I decided to pray for 2 hours. And then after I do it and I go to sleep, don't think the shaitan will leave you. Next day he will come to you and tell you, okay, send to all your email list, telling them about this beautiful experience, trying to take from your reward by making your intention impure, still after doing the work itself. And they say, no, I'm not going to do that. So he pushes one of your coworkers to tell you, why do you have this black spot under your eye? You didn't sleep well yesterday. Shaitan comes and tells you, tell him he will think you were watching TV. Of course, not Qanat al-Huda, maybe other. But he will say you were watching TV. And then when you feel weak and say, okay, I was actually doing something good. What, reading Quran? No, I was standing the night in adoration for Allah, and blah, 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 blah. Now, here comes the problem. Only Allah knows if this will take from your reward or not. If he will take it all, or 90%, or 10%, it's up to Allah. But always try to work on your intention. Keep it pure.
Do we have another question here? We have one more question and a quick response because we're running out of time. Go ahead, please.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
My name is Idris Yad Abdullah from Nigeria. My question is that in Holy Quran, Imam Allah said, لَكَدْ كَانَ رَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَةَ. My question is that, can you describe briefly how a person can imitation the hominess.
How he can imitate the Prophet.
Of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Excellent.
Before you answer it, just to translate the ayat, that verily in the Prophet you have the best of examples. So how would you respond?
What is beautiful about the seerah of Prophet Muhammad, the biographer of Prophet Muhammad, that it kept him as a human being. Today, after more than 1400 years, no Muslim is saying that he is the son of God. He is a human being. So he can be an example for every Muslim. For every husband, he is the example of husbands. For every leader, he is the example. For every friend, he is the example. For every teacher, for every presenter, he is the example. Same thing also, we need to study his seerah or his biography carefully and see how he used to act towards people and how he used to deal with others, how he used to deal with those who help him, with his friends, with women. This is how. He should be the core of our life.
Yes. We are just about out of time.
Okay.
And we're going to have to bring you back again. Now we have an excuse. And we can bring our brother, Fadl Sulaiman, back again, inshallah, where we can continue with this topic or here on our program, Solutions. Our solution here today, our dealings with one another, is to be humble as best you can. And the Prophet ﷺ was the best of examples. So if we can follow his example, inshallah, that will improve our dealings with one another. Wa jazakum Allah li kulli khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Exposing the truth, dispelling lies. What are the differences between the teachings of the church and the teachings of the Bible? Do they really teach the same thing? Is the Bible truly the Word of God? For a comparative study of truth, join me, Arib Islam, only on Peace TV.
Join Arib Islam in comparative study every Wednesday at 3:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 2 a.m. UK on Peace TV. The value of money in the hereafter will be measured by its proper use in the present.
According to the glorious Quran, one of the best ways to use your money is to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by spreading His message of Islam. Peace TV is a non-profit Islamic satellite television channel that is primarily dedicated for just that cause, the proper presentation of Islam. It's a great choice to invest in it and a golden opportunity to purify your wealth in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK. B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1. Sort code 300083. SWIFT BIC code ARAY GB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace TV, the solution for humanity.